Welcome back to another video. This time I will show you my PSVR Aim Controller that comes with a copy of Farpoint for the PS4. There we are. Now, yeah, it's pretty big, right? Where do we start? Okay, so anyway, there's the box for the PlayStation VR Aim Controller, right? It comes with the Farpoint game, and obviously you'll need the PSVR headset and also a camera for this, right? Now the box is quite big, so I'll try to open this with as much grace as possible. Okay, there's the bottom. I'm gonna spin this around, and there is the back. It shows you the PSVR controller itself, the Aim controller itself. It's got integrated sphere and motion sensors, dual stick tool control. It's got twin R1 buttons, so you can play left-handed or right-handed depending on what you are. It's got vibration feedback, rechargeable battery, dedicated triggers, and everything. Okay, it is compatible with PS4. And there is the game itself, right? Farpoint. It's a good game. There it is. Now, like I said, I'm gonna try and open this with as much grace as possible. All right, so bear with me. Okay, so let's take it from the side here. Oh, there we are. Put this away. Okay, and there's the main box. As you can see, there's a, I think this little bit here just helps to, you know, position the another box which sits inside of this, more, I guess, in its place. Okay, let's open the second box. There we are. And we're almost there, folks. We're almost there. This is actually the bottom. Oh, let's turn that around. Okay, there we are. Finally, we're there. Right. Now, just to let you know, this whole, this cardboard, this piece here, it's made from one single cardboard, right? You'll see later on. Now, where is the game, you may ask? You haven't shown us the game. Well, here it is. The game is actually in here, right? In this box here. So all I do is pull this out. There we go. Open this up, and there it is. There is the game, okay? And while we're in this area here, there's the instruction manual for the PSVR Aim controller. There we are, right? The part name, side view, rear view, Perry controller, don't forget to recharge your controller, and then, you know, recommended grip, guaranteed and whatnot, right? There it is. Now, the game itself, right? Farpoint. It's unremarkable, and this one is not to be sold. I'm pretty sure you can buy this game separately, but this one, because it came with the Aim controller, it says not to be sold separately, right? And it tells you you'll need the VR headset and the camera. Without it, you cannot play. Okay, so yeah, to play this game, you need a bit of money to invest. Anyway, there's a back. It's a one-player game, but you can play. I'm pretty sure you can play online co-op with this game, right? Now, inside, like I said before, it's really unremarkable. There's nothing really to it. Contains two things, right? The Blu-ray disc, which is right there. Okay, now I haven't finished this game, by the way. And this leaflet. Okay, now this leaflet shows you two things, right? It shows you the DualShock 4 wireless controller schemes, right, buttons. And it shows you the PSVR Aim controller down the bottom, right there. All right, and on the back, it's just an ad for PS Plus. All right, which is right there. Okay, so that is the game itself. All right, let's put this back in here. And let's close it up. There we are. And now, we come to the best part of the video, the Aim controller itself. Okay, so let's open this up. Now, like I said, this is made from one single cardboard box, and there it is, right? And it's still in pristine condition, let me tell you, right? Let's open this up. Well, there we go. I'll take it from the bottom. There we are. And there it is. Now hold on a second. I'm gonna move this out of the way, right? I'm gonna move this out of the way. There we go. There is the Aim controller. Great. It has a nice weight to it. Not too light, not too heavy, that it strains your arms for an extended period of play. There's a slot at the bottom. Where is it? There it is. Should you want to tie your wrist strap into it? I have it somewhere. It's somewhere. There it is. Playing Farpoint with this gives it a whole another level of immersion. It's very precise and accurate. It's got built-in vibration feedback, meaning that for every shot you take, you can feel the kickback. It's also built for both left-handed and right-handed players. As you can see here, you can play right-handed, right? These are all the buttons. The R1's there. There is the usual PlayStation button with the, I'm guessing this is R3 stick. On top there's a PS button there, that is the touch button. There's another R1 button, so like I said, if you're left-handed and you want to play like that, you know, you can. Options button is right there. D-pad, again, that's the left analog stick. You've got the L1, L2 triggers there. Hopefully you can see it, there it is. Okay. And there is share button, which does not get used at all. Well, for me at least. All in all, it's a good gun controller, right? It's probably one of the best. The only thing that could be better is the micro USB charging port down there. Now, if this was USB-C, perfect. This would be perfect. The other thing is that there isn't that much VR games out there which truly utilizes the aim control. Yeah, okay, there's Farpoint and Firewall Zero Hour, okay? Two of the heavily advertised games that comes bundled with the aim controller, right? But in terms of other popular games out there that can fully utilize the aim controller fully, there's only, Doom VFR, Borderlands 2 VR, Chroma Gun VR, and Arizona Sunshine. There's other lesser known games that can utilize this aim controller, which I probably missed, but really, are they enough to satisfy your cravings for shooters? Maybe not. Okay. Look, I'm not saying that the aim controller is a bad controller, but there should be more games created for it. Okay. I guess if this had come at an earlier stage of the PS4's life, then there may be more games that come out for it. I think it's because this came at a later stage. Hence why there's not a lot of games that came out for it. But anyway, it's pretty good. And also the other thing is, if you want to make these types of PSVR, controllers, maybe making it usable as a standard light gun without the VR aspect would have been great, like a normal PS Move gun, right? Because, this is basically a PS Move orb at the front. Anyway, there we have it, folks. The bundled PSVR aim controller with Farpoint 4. The PS3, okay? There it is. That's how you kind of hold it. There's a trigger there. So, and like I said, it's nicely weighted, okay? Anyway, don't forget to like and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this. Yes, it's a bit short. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!